Very good morning, children. So today we'll continue chapter cell. See, first of all, cell is a basic structural and functional unit of living organisms. Okay. And here there are many millions of cells in plants as well as animals. Okay. So there was little confusion in the scientist. So one scientist, when they started studying about cell, it is a continuation of the chapter only. So there was a scientist called Robert Leeuwenhoek. So Leeuwenhoek was a scientist. So what he did, he developed one microscope. He was very interested, so he developed one microscope to observe the microbes, because which cannot be, we cannot see the microbes with our naked eyes. So developed a simple microscope which had only one lens. So he tried it by using sunlight, but it was up to the mark. It was okay, but not up to the mark. Okay. So after some years, Robert Hooke, he observed, he also made a simple microscope with two lenses. Okay. So he observed the cells of dead, I told already we discussed here. So he took cork cells which are around the stem. So he said that the cells are like compartments. Okay. So after some years, like after nearly 150 years after the invention of microscope on magnifying lenses, and magnifying lenses were found, so gradually people started showing interest. Okay. There are two scientists called Sclidin and Squam. So these scientists studied about the cell by using microscope, and they came to a conclusion that, so that they gave cell theory. So cell theory, what does it tell? First one is, cells are the basic unit of living organism. Cells are the basic unit of living organism. All the living organisms are made up of cells. First of all the living organisms are made up of cells. Cells are the basic unit of all living organisms. So these are the two theories about cell. So that is why they call it cell theory. And after some years, there was one more scientist called Virchow. So he gave one clarity about cell, that cell will arise from pre-existing cell, means cells are formed from the pre-existing cell, means if one cell is there, this cell has come from earlier cell. So that there are the two theories about cell. So one is cell theory given by Theodore and Squam. All living organisms are made up of cells. Cell is the basic and structural unit of all living organisms. Okay. And Virchow said that all the cells, whatever the existing cells are there, they are coming from, or they are rising from the, we are getting them from the pre-existing cells. So they were the cell theories. Okay. Then coming to size of the cells. You know very well, size of the cell is very small, that we cannot see with our naked eyes. Then there are some cells like nerve cell, which are unicellular organism cell, which we cannot see with our naked eyes. Okay. So for that they use microscope. Okay. Multicellular cells we are able to see with our naked eyes. Okay. And when you come to size of the cell, I told one small cell of any living organism will be 1/1000th of a millimeter. Means it is called 1 micron. Okay. The smallest cell is of virus. Very small. The smallest is virus. So biggest cell is ostrich egg, is very big egg. Nearly 15 centimeter long and 18 centimeter wide, and it is very big cell only, it's single cell only. Okay. And after studying about cell, then come to shape of cell. Cells are very long. When you say very long, nerve cell which is on our body is nearly, it is 1 meter long. 1 meter long. Okay. So this is about shape, size. I think some of the cells are having shape, some of the cells do not have shape, like WBC continuously go on changing shape. Okay. So most of the cells are in different shape, like round, spherical, okay, elongated, spindle shaped, different shapes there. Okay, RBC is like biconvex, biconcave, lens like lens, it looks like lens only, RBC. Okay, so this is about size and shape and about cell. Then coming to main part, what is cell? and what is plant cell organism. Before that, we will try to find what is the difference between the unicellular organism and multicellular organisms. Okay. So, unicellular organisms, what they have? They are made up of single cell. Multicellular organisms are made up of many number of cells, and those cells are again specialized to organelles and they form organ system. Many cells are there. Okay. So, unicellular organisms or unicellular organisms perform all the functions, all the physiological functions by using only one cell. But multicellular organisms perform all the activities or all the functions of the body or physiological functions by using different systems, because they develop into organ and organ system in that way. Okay. And lifespan of living unicellular organisms is very short. They are very short lived, and lifespan of multicellular organisms is very large. They are very long lived. Okay. So unicellular organisms are very delicate in nature, and multicellular organisms are very strong in nature. So these are about the difference between unicellular and multicellular organisms. Okay. Then coming back to cell wall. When you say cell, cell means again we have one is plant cells and animal cells. Okay. So plant cells and animal cells. First of all, when you take the shape of the cell, plant cell have particular shape. Okay. It has a particular shape and it may not change. It will not change. But animal cells may, it may be little round, little different shapes, it may go on changing. But animal's plant cell is stiff. Okay. And here, what are the structures, what are the parts of the cell we will try to find? Okay. So first of all, commonly, see, what this cell, animal cell, plant cell, what they have in common? In common, all of them are having some basic structures which are present inside, like nucleus. Cytoplasm is there, Protoplasm is there, So most of the things are similar, but based on their different organelles present in them, they differ in their functions. Okay. Then what about cell, plant cell and animal cell? So plant cell is made, is first of all, what? It has two layers. It is double membrane. Why? Outer layer is covered with hard structure. It is hard in nature. It is tougher because it is made up of what? Cellulose. Means cell wall is strong. So due to that strong cell wall, okay, this cell wall has some pores on it, small pores, holes are there, so that some of the substances can enter very rarely, but most of the substance will go outside through the cell wall. So cell wall is a permeable membrane. It is a permeable membrane, little permeable, pores are there. Okay, so cell membrane is inside. Cell membrane is very clear, whatever the substance are required, only it will enter, it will allow to enter, otherwise it will not allow to enter cell membrane. Okay. The same case in the case of animals. See, that's why animal cells are weaker than plant cells. Or generally animals are weaker and from plants, because cell wall is made up of sometimes lignin, sometimes cellulose, sometimes pectin, different types of cells or different type of structures where they make it stronger. Okay, but cell wall, cell membrane is only present in the what? Animal cell. So cell, plant cell contains both cell wall, cell membrane. Animal cell contains only cell membrane. But what is the function of this? This also help in removal of waste or entry of some useful substances. They will enter through the membrane. So this also is a semi-permeable membrane. Okay, I'll give one nice example. You take dry fruits like dry grapes. Okay, so those dry grapes, if you put in water, what happens there? After some 1 or 2 hours, it will soak. It will soak because it will absorb water, because it has only what, like that only cell membrane allows only some substances through it, and whatever the waste it is there, it will throw out. Okay, so cell membrane. So coming to internal, we go inside. Here, this completely cell wall of plants or cell wall of animals. It contains a living structure called protoplasm. What is what it contains? Protoplasm. Okay, so it contains a living material, living substance called protoplasm. Inside the protoplasm, again, there is a nucleus which is denser in structure. Which is dense, look like dark structure. Main part of the cell is nucleus in animal cell or plant cell. Okay. And one more structure there is present is cytoplasm. Main parts of cell is, first of all, cell wall, plant cell, cell wall, cell membrane, protoplasm. In protoplasm there is cytoplasm and nucleus. Okay. And we'll study one by one. What does cytoplasm contain? Again, in the cytoplasm, there are some structures called or double membraned layers called cell organelles. They all help in functioning of the cell, whether it is in animal cell or plant cell. They help in the functioning. What is the work? What is that we'll do? What they help in? We'll try to find. Okay. So, first of all, we'll come to nucleus. There is a nucleus here. Nucleus is very small in size in the case of plant cell, and vacuoles are large in number. Vacuoles are bigger in size. Why vacuoles are bigger in size, we'll discuss later. Okay, so nucleus is the central part of any living organism. It will control all the activities of the cell. All the activities of the cell is controlled by the nucleus. So, nucleus is covered by one membrane called nuclear membrane. This is a nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane. Okay. Again, inside the nucleus, there is one small structure called nucleolus. Smaller than one structure is called nucleus. Nucleolus. Okay. So, this liquid jelly-like structure present in this nucleus is called nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm. Okay. And this nucleus is having two surfaces covered. One is, we call endoplasmic reticulum. One is smooth and one is rough. But what is the function of them? Okay, see, whatever the energy is given, supplied, or whatever the energy is required for the all plants for their development, it is controlled, it is given by the what? Nucleus. Okay. And see, smooth endoplasmic reticulum means, it is smooth means what? It does not have protein. But rough means it has protein, it helps to development of the cell. Okay. Then, there are some structures, especially very important is structures present in plant cell are plastids. Okay. So, in plant cell, plastids are there. And you see here. Suppose, you see, nucleus is present here in animal cell and in plant cell also nucleus is present. Nuclear membrane is present in animal cell, nuclear, both of them are there, nuclear membrane, nucleolus, nuclear membrane, all are there. Okay, and it has chromatin here, it has a structure called chromatin. Who is this? Animal cell is a structure called chromatin. And there is endoplasmic reticulum, one is smooth, one is rough. So, rough endoplasmic reticulum contains a small dot-like structure, they are called rough endoplasmic. They are helping in protein formation or protein synthesis. They help to prepare the protein in plants as well as animals. Okay. And most of the food is prepared and stored in a place called vacuole. That's why large number of a big vacuole is present in the what? Plant cell. But vacuole is very small. Here, so one or two we find, because animals cannot store food. Okay. And only plants can store food in the form of vacuole, which contains starch, proteins, carbohydrates, all are present in the starch, and they help in the functioning of the body. Okay. Then what are plastids? I told plastids are present in animal, sorry, plant cell, but plastids are animals, in animal cell they are absent. Why? Okay. Plastids are green which give pigment to the plants, which give color to the plants. In that again we have three types. Which are those? Chloroplast, chromoplast, leucoplast. Chloroplast means what? Chloroplast are present in the green parts of the cell. All the leaves contain chloroplast. Because chloroplast help in taking the food, taking the light sunlight, preparing food and sending to all parts of the body. Chloroplast work is absorbing sunlight, preparing food. Okay. Chromoplast means what? So these chromoplasts are present in what? Red, blue, green, yellow colored flowers or fruits or sepals or petals. This chromoplasts are represented there. They are, because you don't think that only plastids are only one single. They're different varieties of colors are there. So they help to prepare the what? Food in by using sunlight. It's chloroplast is there, chromoplast is there, and one more is leucoplast. Leucoplast is colorless. They are actually colorless. They help in preparing starch or glucose in the plant cell. They help in that. Okay. Now, there is one more important structure called Golgi bodies. Okay. So, what is the function of Golgi bodies? They help in synthesizing the food and distributing the food. Okay. They act as storage of food. Okay. See. So, in this nucleus, there are some thread-like structure. You can see thread-like structure here also, here also. So, these thread-like structure are called what? Chromatin network. We call chromatin. Chromatin. Okay. So in the plant cell it is there, but in animal cell it plays important role because chromatin network combines coils and form what? Chromosomes. So those chromosomes contain structure called genes. What? Genes. So genes are the carriers of character. They are carrying, transferring character from one parent to other parent. So okay, in the plant cell they are present. In the plant animal cell they are there, but they help in what? Transfer of characters from one parent to offspring, children. So what are the character parent is having? All the whole characters are sent to the children. Okay. So there is one important, very important structure which is called mitochondria. Very important, because this is called powerhouse of the cell only. It's called power of the cell, and nucleus is called brain. We have brain center of the cell, brain of the cell. So brain controls all activities of the cell and help for the activities of the cell. That's why it's called brain cell of the cell. And mitochondria is called powerhouse of the cell because it helps in oxidizing. It helps in oxidizing and preparing food. And whatever the food is prepared, it helps to oxidize and convert into glucose and energy. It is, that's why it's called powerhouse of the cell. So mitochondria is present in animal cell as well as plant cell. Okay. So these ribosomes help in what? Protein synthesis. What is the protein required for the body? They will help to prepare the food. Okay. Then coming to one more part is called centriole. Here is a centriole, centrosome. What is the function of them? See. Here the cell divides. In plant cell what we have? We have meristematic tissue, and afterwards some years, after the adult, they become permanent tissues. But in the case of animals, there is continuous repairing of cells. Whenever you fall down, whenever you are continuously growing in size, shape and increasing in the weight and all, this centrosome help in cell division. That's in cell division, because these cells will again divide. 1 becomes 2, 2 becomes 4, 4 becomes 8. It goes on dividing. So centriole cell in cell division. Then what is the work of lysosome? Very interesting. Lysosomes are called suicide bags. Means what? Actually, what do they do? They contain enzymes and hormones. These enzymes, what they will do? Whatever the poisonous things are present in the animal cell, they will digest. they will eat it and digest. Sometimes what happens, they only die, they eat themselves. They swallow themselves and they die away. So lysosomes are called suicide bats. Okay. So these are the difference between plant cell as well as animal cell. So first of all, what are the difference? Plant cell is made up of cell wall. Animal cell doesn't contain cell wall. Animal cell and plant cell, both of them are in cell membrane. Okay. And nucleus is present at the edge, at the margin in the plant cell. Nucleus is at the center of the cell in the animal cell. Okay. In plant cell, vacuole is large in size and it is prominent. It is very important. Larger in size means stores more food. That is a plant store food for us. Okay. In animals, very small, even though they are present, they are very small in size. Vacuoles are very small in size. They are very smaller in size, vacuoles. Okay. So cytoplasm contains all the cell organelles. So cell organelles are helping for the development and growth of the body. Okay. Then chromosomes are present in animal cell and plant cell. But what are chromosomes? That you should know. See, human beings are having 23 pairs of chromosomes. How many are there? 23 pairs of chromosome. Out of 23 pairs means it is 23 into 2 pairs, I told, 46. Okay. So 22 is chromosome which help for the growth of the body and all things. But one will tell about the sex, whether a person is boy or a girl. So that is detected by animal cell. Okay. XY is present in males. Chromosome XY is present in males. Chromosome XX is present in females. So based on that only, you are identified as a boy or a girl. So they will help for the identification. So chromatin network will coil and convert into chromosome. So the chromosome contains genes. Genes are passing from one parent to, or one generation to generation. That's why you are like your grandfather, or your grandfather like, maybe like your forefather, four grandfather. So all the cattle are passing from one generation to other generation. Okay. So cytoplasm is present in both sides, and mitochondria is present in both animals and plant cells. They help to synthesize, oxidize the food material. They help in supply of oxygen and food for the all parts of the body. In this way, we found the difference between plant cell as well as animal cell. Okay. So please read textbook, understand it, and it will be conceptually little clear when you open the textbook and read. Simply don't see, watch the video and sit there. Along with the textbook, you should keep the video and read it and try to understand it. Thank you. Have a nice day.